In order to create buttons for our UI form, we have to perform two steps. First one, we have to edit our UI component form.xml file and add configuration for new buttons. And secondly, we have to create PHP classes that are going to be responsible for our back and save buttons. Let's go ahead and open MageMastery blog post form.xml file. And inside, let's add configuration of our buttons. Configuration should go inside settings XML tag, and it should start with buttons, and inside we can declare individual buttons. In order to declare a button or add it into a form, we have to provide a name of a button. Usually it's basically a purpose of a button. In our case, a first button name is going to be save, and a class that is going to be responsible for rendering a button. We are going to have two buttons, save and back. And let's add names of our classes. These classes are not available at the moment, so we will add names and then we will implement these classes in our Magento 2 block module. Name space of a class that has to be provided into class argument is going to be MageMastery block, then block admin HTML. Post, edit, and name of a PHP class, save button. Similar to a back button, but name of a class is going to be back. This is a configuration required for adding two buttons on our UI form. Let's go ahead and implement PHP classes for these buttons. And first of all, let's create a directory structure. So this is going to be block admin HTML post edit, and inside this directory we're going to have a first class. Let's call it save button. All buttons should implement interface that is called button provider interface. And as you can see, it's coming from Magento Framework View Element UI Component Control Namespace. And we can implement a method getButtonData. So it's going to be an array. It's a configuration of a button. And this configuration should go with a label. And we are going to name our label as save, a CSS class. Let's use primary and save CSS classes. So visually this is going to be a primary button. Then sort order of this button, let's put 20, and data attribute that is going to be responsible for configuration of a button, where we have to provide additional configuration that says that this is a save button, and on click event of this button we have to trigger save event. And MageInit is basically allows our button to initialize additional JavaScript functionality so this button can work and perform operations. And form role save. This is a save button. Let's go ahead and implement back button. This button also has to implement button provider interface. And we should provide configuration of this button inside getButtonData. Label. So this is going to be, if you are not familiar with this function, underscore, underscore, and brackets, it's a translation function of a Magento. It's a global function that can be used across the different PHP, PHTML files and so on. It allows to support translations. So, and usually all text within Magento 2 modules should come inside this translation function. For a back button, we have to provide on click. This is going to be location href z. We will give back URL. So this getback URL or on click will allow us to redirect our user back to our post grid page. Class is going to be back. So this is a predefined CSS class within Magento admin. And sort order, let's put 10. And finally, let's implement private function getback URL. So this function will return a string. Make sure to avoid these additional namespaces that are coming from tests, so your code will not break. And inside, we have to write something like get URL and provide a location of our back URL button. So basically it says that we have to use route and controller. However, as you can see, we don't have get URL method. And in order to add this get URL, let's go ahead and implement a parent class or a PHP class generic button class that is going to be responsible for, let's set a construct, and this class will allow us to inject URL interface dependency URL. As you can see, I'm using PHP 8.0 syntax that allow me to skip creating class variables and just provide visibility modificator within a construct argument. So this argument will be provided via construct method and will be assigned into private variable called URL. And then we can use this dependency. As you can see, we have URL dependency added and provide a method called getURL with route and params. But we have to also add arguments that are going to be used and passed to getURL method. So first argument is string route, and second one is params. It's array. We can go back to backButton class, add generic button method, and we have this getURL method that is coming from generic button class. This generic button can be used for other buttons we're going to create during this course. For example, delete button that will also require getURL when we will create a delete button class. And with these three PHP classes, backButton, generic button, and save button, as well as configuration for adding this button save and back, we can successfully render two new buttons on a page. And these buttons are rendered as a toolbar panel of a UI form for new post. And when we click back, we will be redirected back to our manage posts page. And when we click save, it should save content of our form. However, since we don't have implementation of a save controller, this form will not be saved. Actual submission will happen, but this submission and form save is something we're going to cover in our next lesson.